Luis Gerardo Mendez with us now. Look at that superstar face joining our Zoom. Great to see you, man. How you doing, Luis?
I'm great, man. Thanks for having me on your show. I'm really excited.
Of course. So I want to know, when you, when it was obviously pre-pandemic, and you would walk the streets of Mexico City, could you get down the street, or were people just stopping you everywhere you went?
Yeah, that's a tricky situation. Yeah, that started like 5 years ago after a film I did. I think one of the perks, I think the only perk of the pandemic is the mask. Sometimes it's helpful to do the groceries. Yeah, it is.
You know him from Murder Mystery on Netflix, and also that latest remake of Charlie's Angels. But Luis, massive star in Mexico, so he can't walk down the streets, but he can get a table at one of the popular restaurants that I see on Chef's Table.
That's amazing. Yeah, that's true.
And so I didn't realize, and you know, Patty and I were talking about you earlier, I didn't realize how much we have in common.
Oh, really? Please hit me.
You were born in 1982, right?
Oh, yeah, that's true.
What month?
March.
December of 74, right here. Now,
dude,
okay.
I mean, probably you are my half brother, my real half brother.
The movie may be based on our relationship. But
yes.
I have a black lab and you have a chocolate lab, I read.
Oh my God, this is getting really weird.
I know. The fact that we haven't spent time in person together is freaking me out, Luis.
Yeah. Do you also live in LA?
I do.
Oh my God.
And I mean, I can walk down the street with people, you know, not really bothering
That's
me.
That's not
fine.
True. You can't walk down the street with
people. People don't bug me. I love it. I actually asked him, would you like a picture with me? I'm Luis's friend. Hey, what's your dog's name? Tuba?
Tuba, yeah, Tuba. She's actually right here. Tuba, come.
Tuba,
well, no, it's gonna be a lot of mess. Forget it.
Tuba,
but she's here. Oh, look. She's not that. Okay. She just wants to say hi.
Let's see Tuba.
Hi, say hi,
oh,
Tuba.
Oh my God.
So she's really famous too. She's really famous. She's the face of PETA in Latin America.
Oh, is that right?
Oh, wow.
Yes, yes. She's one of. Yeah, she's more famous than me.
Well, look at you putting the dog to work.
Yeah.
So let's get down to business. You mentioned Half Brothers. This is very exciting, which is now in select theaters. But this is a breakthrough role in a way, isn't it?
It's a really big deal for me. It's the first time I'm producing a film in the States. I've been producing most of the stuff I've been doing in Mexico. I did the first Netflix show for Latin America and in Spanish, Club of Crows, like 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. But this is the first time I'm producing something in the US with a studio like Focus Features, which, by the way, they made my favorite films when I was in my 20s.
Wow.
So yeah, that, you know, like Little Miss Sunshine or Burn After Reading, Eternal Sunshine, blah, blah, blah. So suddenly I was developing a film with them. So I was really happy and I was terrified at the same time because it was a completely different experience. You know, like Hollywood is a different animal. It has different rules and you have so much more pressure. But yeah, I was really happy. And this is the first time I'm the lead in an American film. So yeah, I mean, I'm happy. I'm grateful. It's really weird to open a film in the middle of a pandemic, but at the same time, the way I see it is like I'm really grateful because what I think is if we can bring joy to people in this horrible year, you know, in Christmas for the audience to go to the theaters or see the film in their houses in a couple of weeks and see Half Brothers and have a good time and laugh and in the best case scenario maybe cry a little bit, that's great. I'm happy with that.
I mean, you know, I give Patty credit for introducing me to Half Brothers and telling me about it. And you're how do you take on stereotypes in this movie? What are you doing with stereotypes in this film?
Well, really hard. We're crushing those stereotypes. Like for me, it was really important to portray my character is this really successful businessman from Mexico. He has an aviation company and is the lead of the film. We've never seen a character like that in Hollywood, you know? And for me, being Mexican, it's really important to see myself represented in the Hollywood screen the way I want to see myself represented in the Hollywood screen. You know, it's not just about having Mexican characters in your shows or your films. It's about telling the stories that are important to us, you know? And that was really important for me. And also, I mean, this is a comedy. You're going to have a great time laughing about all these stereotypes about Mexicans and Americans. Like for me, I mean, all of the lines you're going to see in the film, those are things that happened to me, you know, like, right. Oh, are you from Mexico? Oh, I love Cancun. I love ziplining. And he's like, dude, that's not the most important. I mean, ziplining is not even Mexican, you know, like, so
ziplining.
yeah, exactly. And the same with Americans, because my character is really interesting. My character is this Mexican kid. When he was young, his father, who was actually his best friend, goes to the US in the search for a better life and a job, and he never comes back. You're gonna see in the film why he never comes back. So basically my character is so sad and angry because his dad left him in Mexico. So he hates America. So this Mexican guy, he doesn't wanna go to the States. He hates the States because in his way of seeing life, America took his father. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so having that fish out of the water in the States with that's his really annoying brother, half brother, whose best talent is posting his breakfast on Instagram, give us a lot of comedy and contrast between these two cultures, you know?
Well, it's, that's I awesome. Mean, it really is. It is very funny and can't wait for people to see it. Half Brothers now in select theaters. Luis, thank you for coming on. We appreciate it. I hope to talk to you real soon and much success with this, okay?
Thanks so much, Ryan. Thanks to your team and thanks to everyone listening.
See you, buddy. Bye-bye.